Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning all. First of all, there's Mrs. Nigmatuni Aya as a lecturer who teaches research methodology course. I'm also friends who watches this video. Here, I am Turatun Nasiha, IK3C, Semarang State Polytechnic, and will present the final project proposal with the title Comparative Analysis of Broad Raw Material Inventory Control Using the EAQ Method Case Study X Company. Okay, the present structure is first, background, second, formulation of the problem, third, purpose, fourth, benefit, five, literature review, and six, business method. Let's go straight to the first discussion, namely the background of the research. The main goal of a company is to earn the highest profit. To achieve its goals, the company must be able to have a good management system in running its business, including inventory management. Whether a company inventory management is effective or not is reflected in meeting customer needs and not excessive production. The purpose of inventory management itself is to minimize production cost as small as possible with the highest profitability. If a company makes a mistake in comparing the size of raw materials ordered with its needs, there will be losses due to the amount of inventory bank to hit, resulting in losses through cost. But if it is too low, it can also increase cost because the company continues to incur repeated purchasing costs. As company is a manufacturing company that produces food products, namely various types of bread. Bread is made from ingredients that do not last long, such as flour, eggs, sugar, and other supporting ingredients. So far, the process of controlling raw material at X company only uses estimates and past experiences in processing raw material. The problem in this company is the occurrence of excess inventory, so that material stock costs will be high and disposal of material that are no longer suitable for use because they have been stored for too long. By improving X company inventory control system, it is habit that it will provide positive result so that profitability increases. Next, the problem formulation of this research includes first, how is inventory control calculated if it is not accordance with the policies used by the company? Second, how is inventory control implemented and calculated using the EAQ method? Third, what is the comparison between the policies used by the company and the EAQ method in internal control inventory as company? Then, the purpose and benefit of conducting this research are, the purpose is to first, analyze and calculate inventory costs according to the policy used by the company. Second, analyze and calculate inventory costs using the EAQ method. Third, analyze which internal control system for the company is appropriate to use. The benefits obtained are, first, become a reference and additional information for future research. Second, is one of the considerations for companies is carrying or their business activities. Third, increase insight for the public and provide information on how important inventory control is in a business. The next topic of discussion is a literature review, which will discuss 1. Understanding inventory, 2. Type of inventory, 3. EAQ definition and formula, and 4. Safety stock, lead time, and reorder point. What is meant by inventory? Inventory is a number of material or goods that are stored for the production process or result in the future. Type of inventory based on the type and position of goods, namely raw material inventory, inventory or processed product, inventory of auxiliary material or equipment, inventory of semi-finished goods or goods in process, and finished goods inventory. What is EAQ? EAQ or economy order quantity is an inventory control technique to minimize total cost or ordering and storage. To find the EAQ itself, you need to do a calculating use the following formula. First, look for ordering cost. Ordering cost is equal to D divided by T times S. then look for holding cost. Holding costs are equal to E divided by 2 times H. Next, calculate the inventory cost of the goods, namely by adding ordering cost to holding cost. And finally, look for the EQ value, namely the root of 2ST divided by H. Explanation: Q is number of item per order, E is demand for inventory item in units, S is ordering cost for each order, H is total stock cost per unit per year, TIC is total inventory cost. Next, safety stock, lead time, and reorder point. Safety stock. Safety stock is additional supplies held to protect or guard against the possibility of shortage of material. Stock up. For the formula, you can view the screen. Lead time. Lead time is a lag of time between the start of ordering material until the arrival of the ordered material. Factor that need to be considered in determining lead time are 1. Stock or costs that must be incurred due to delay in the arrival of raw material. 2. Extra carrying costs are costs that have to be incurred due to delay in raw material arriving early. And reorder point. Reordering is a point or limit of the amount of inventory available for time where order must be placed again. For the formula, you can view in screen. The final discussion concerns reset methodology. It discusses several things, namely understanding reset methodology, type of reset, data type, method of collecting data analysis method, and write method. Understanding reset methodology. Research methods are a science that study method or technique that direct researchers to choose appropriate patterns and procedures in obtaining data, analyzing it, and presenting report well and informatively. Type of research. 1. Cost research is research using a special cost as a research object. 2. Descriptive research is research that attempts to explain solution to current problem based on data analyzing and interpreting. Data type of data according to availability. 1. Qualitative data. Qualitative data is data that cannot be measured and does not inform numbers, company history, and company organizational structure. 2. Quantitative data. Quantitative data is completeness, is usually data and that can be measured and is the form of numbers. Total inflow inventory, movement in floor inventory, and total floor inventory in the financial position report. Type of data according to their nature. 1. Primary data. Primary data is usually taken directly through observation, interview, and observation. The result of inventory obtained from accounting staff at X company, the procurement and condition of floor supplies, and the result of interview with material management managers X company. Secondary data. Secondary data is obtained indirectly by through intermediaries. The company profile, movement in floor inventory, and the sale or of floor inventory. Method of collecting data. Interview. An interview is question and answer process in research then takes place orally in which two or more people face to face. Interviews were conducted with general laser supervision regarding the problem of treating floor supplies and with material managers regarding floor inventory to offer. Documentary studies. This method is used to obtain information through existing document in the company. In collecting data to obtain information, the data taken is regarding the company profile, movement in floor inventory, and the details of floor inventory. Data analysis method. 1. Collect the recorded data such as total of floor inventory mutation, and the amount of floor inventory in the financial position report. 2. Identify the treatment of floor supplies. 3. Select and sort floor suppliers that are suitable for factory operation and those that are no longer suitable for factory operation. 4. Select and sort for supplies that are not suitable for operation in the first supplies that have selling value and those that do not. 5. Calculate the amount of floor inventory that has selling value and does not. 6. Removing the amount of floor inventory that has no selling value from the total floor inventory that is no longer suitable for factory operation. 7. Calculate profit or loss from estimated sales of floor inventory that still has sales value. 8. Present the amount of profit or loss on floor inventory sold in the comprehensive income report. And 9. Present the actual amount of floor inventory by excluding floor inventory that is no longer suitable for factory in operation. And writing method. 1. Description method. This description method will describe something according to the chart. In the financial assessment, the description method is used to describe the profile, policies, and organizational structure of X company. 2. Expositional method. Expositional is a classification that purpose to provide information, explanation, description, or explanation including exports. In this financial assessment, the expositional method is used to explain the treatment and calculation of floor supplies from X company. The schedule for participation in the research is in the script. That's now for the presentation of my financial proposal. I apologize for the advantages and disadvantages. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.